Hey guys, I'm Volen, and in this series I'll be making my own video editor by using the Godot game engine. You may have questions like, why make a video editor? Why use a game engine? Why use Godot? How will your video editor work and what will make it special? Why will you spend hundreds of hours making something which you won't be paid for? Let's start by answering the first question. Why make a video editor? As some people might know already, I'm using Linux, and the amount of support for video editors on Linux is very limited compared to Windows, for example. Yes, we have programs like Caden Live, but it crashes quite frequently. We also have DaVinci Resolve, great editor on Windows, but on Linux you cannot even use MP4 files because there is no H264 codec support. And even if you pay the Yuanyuan, around $400 for the studio version, you still don't even have AAC audio support. So most of your MP4 files you still need to convert so you can use audio. There's also the Olive video editor, which is another free and open source video editor like Caden Live, for example. But whilst development is being made, it is still far from being a usable replacement like Caden Live, for example. And then there's also Lightworks, which is also a professional video editor, but the free version only allows 720p renders. One of the last ones on the list is Adobe with Premiere Pro. Oh wait, yeah, no, that one does not even work on Linux because they just don't give a about Linux. They keep refusing to make a Linux port even though people have been asking for it for such a long time now. Now there are some more video editors on Linux, but they all lack in one way or another. And some of them are just not intuitive to use at all, with some of them not even working properly on different distros. So it's time to listen to my parents and I'll take their advice. If you want something to be done good, do it yourself. And that's exactly what I'll be doing. But why use Godot to make a video editor? It's a game engine. Basically for the simple reason that it gives me a good UI system. It's very easy to create a UI in it. It's also open source, so if I need to add things with C++, for example, I could easily implement it myself and just create a custom version of the engine. That still doesn't explain why a game engine, and that's basically because I want to use the 3D and 2D functions, like the 2D, 3D capabilities, because those will kind of allow a lot of advanced features which I want to implement. And which I don't want to spend another couple hundred hours on developing myself. The main reason why I'll be using Godot is to save time. And because I actually see a use case for all the extra features a game engine could give me. Again, I'm using Linux, so Godot is my best option if I want to use a game engine. But overall, I have the most experience with Godot and I really like how good the documentation is. You can basically find out how to do anything, plus the community is very helpful. If I run into some kind of trouble, I could easily ask some of the other couple hundred developers, like people who know how the engine works. And other game engines just aren't good enough in my opinion for this. Like we have Unity, but it runs like on Linux the last time I tried it. Plus their reputation is going down quite quickly, so I kind of want a stable platform with a stable future. And there's no denying that Unreal Engine is quite a powerful engine, but yeah, I'm not in the mood to compile the entire engine every single time when there's an update, because that's how it works on Linux. And next up, how will my video editor work and how will it be different compared to others like Caden Live or DaVinci Resolve? So first of all, I want to make it free and open source, and I also want to make it modular. My goal is to keep the engine as small as possible whilst creating a lot of possibilities for people who know a bit about programming to create extra modules for it that other people can add to their editor, which improves the functionality overall. That way I will have less work creating all the special effects or compositions, by example, and I can just leave that over to other people whilst I mainly focus on the core part of the video editor. So I want to create a modular system for the video editor. This may work quite well, and a lot of people will like it and make their own modules that they share with other people, open, free and open source, or maybe paid if they want to. Or maybe it's kind of a terrible experience and nobody wants to use it, but at least, like, how can we know if I don't try to make it? My goal is for this editor to become one of the most used video editors on Linux. That's one of my goals. My goal for this thing is to create a learning experience for both me and you, and hopefully in the process we can create something very usable that Linux users will appreciate, and in the future possibly also Windows users. But and yeah, I know this channel is called Voilent's Game Dev Journey. This channel will contain both game development but also other programming related stuff, like this project of creating a video editor, which will probably be a very, very long project. In the next video, I'll probably go over some naming, because I still don't have a name for this. I was thinking about Voilent X, but that sounds a little bit too bad. That will be something that I'll discuss in the next video. Hopefully some people will be interested, be watching and giving some advice on good names for the video editor made with Godot. The first couple of videos will mainly be about creating the UI part of the whole engine, because that will be probably be the most interesting part to look at for people who quickly want to like see how the project is going, so we have something visual to show. After that, I'll be going more into the back end part with all the programming and coding and such, which will be the most painful part to make, but I'm looking forward to it. If you want to discover how this journey goes, please click subscribe in one of these corners, I always forget which one it is. And click the bell icon so you stay up to date with the latest development videos of this video editor. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.